Hello friends, welcome to this online series of lectures on Industry 4.0. In this particular lecture, we will be focusing on one of the key technology of Industry 4.0, that is augmented reality. We will introduce a new topic, augmented reality. We will introduce it, we will see what the definitions is, what are the applications point of view, where this augmented reality is being used in the industries, and some of the future scope of augmented reality. So let's start. So let's look into the definition of augmented reality. So augmented reality is the experience, you can say interactive experience of the virtual world. So how do you get this virtual world? You use the computerized information with the help of perceptual information with the help of a computer. So you overlay this kind of information, perceptual information like visual, auditory, haptic, these kind of informations is overlaid onto the camera view, or you can say display devices, with the help of this computer vision or different sensing technologies. One of the key component, one of the example I can give you is Google Glass, or you can say Microsoft HoloLens. These devices use augmented and mixed reality. To give you an example, I want to show you one of the video of US military. They extensively use augmented reality into their day-to-day operations, military operations. Let's look into it.
OP6, this is Command. S2 reports that your AOR is the subject of increased net chatter. Possible.
Let's go.
Now, here you might have seen many of the applications in the military operation, but I want to point out on one of the applications where they were very difficult to locate one of the drone, right? Target drone. And with the help of tracking mechanism, as well as these devices called smart glasses, they were easily can be located, and they can, that kind of informations can be overlaid on the smart glass screen so that you can easily visualize where the target is. So these kind of applications are possible with the help of augmented reality. Now let's look into three key features of the augmented reality, starting with the combination of real and the virtual world. Here you can see from the previous example that the real world was the camera view, and virtual world, they have superimposed the information, perceptual information on the top of the real world. So that is the combination, augmented reality is the combination of virtual and real world. Then you have real-time interactions. You might have seen that with the movement of head and movement of hands, it's still the information was getting updated in real time. So that kind of interactions is possible, real-time interaction is possible within the augmented reality. Then you have accurate 3D registrations. If we talk about the virtual world, the virtual objects as well as the real objects, you have to have this 3D registration, at least accurate in case of augmented reality. Now let's look into the extended reality. Now augmented reality comes under the umbrella term of extended reality, which is also one of the key technology of Industry 4.0. So starting with the virtual reality. What do you mean by virtual reality? It is the immersed experience. Here, apart from the augmented reality where you have the real world as well as the virtual world, in virtual reality, the user is transported into the virtual world. And it can he or she can experience this virtual world by using this head-mounted displays. So that is the virtual reality. Then we have the augmented reality. Augmented reality, as we have seen in the previous examples, you have these smart glasses or Google Glass, for example, where the perceptual information is overlaid on the top of the screens, or you can say camera view, so that you can easily visualize and you can get the more information with the help of this virtual world. So that is the augmented reality. And finally, we have the mixed reality, where the user can interact virtual objects as well as the physical world both at the same time in the mixed reality. The prime example of mixed reality is the Microsoft HoloLens, and the company is also coming up with the Microsoft HoloLens 2. You can check out the videos about the applications of the Microsoft HoloLens 2. Now let's look into the type of augmented reality. What are the different types or different kinds of augmented reality we are dealing with? Starting with the marker based, where the user have to put the marker or tag onto the place where he or she wants to get the augmented reality. Here the marker is placed on the white paper where you have the trackers. This code based trackers are used, vision cameras are used, so that it can track it and place the virtual object on the top. So this is marker based AR augmented reality, where markerless is similar to kind of the applications where we have found in the Google Maps, where you have the physical locations as well as the name of that location on the top of this virtual camera view. So that is the markerless AR. Moving on, we have location based augmented reality, as we have discussed Google Maps, for example, where with the help of GPS tracking, you have different locations where you can find, say, let's say, for example, coffee shop is here. Just by overlaying this information on the top of this camera view, you can get within the application of Google Maps. So this is the example of location based AR. Then you have superimposed augmented reality. Superimposition means here in this particular real hand, the image, the 3D image of this radius bone of hand is superimposed, so that you can easily visualize where it can fit and what are the components of this hand or radius bones. And also you can get the information, perceptual information on the top within this application of augmented reality. So that is the example of superimposition based augmented reality. Then we have projection based, where, for example, here in this image, you have the projection of dialer from the mobile. The image is, this dialer image is projected on the hand, and you can literally dial the numbers with the help of this augmented reality. So projection based augmented reality, and you can easily call the other person with the help of this kind of AR. So this is one of the category, projection based augmented reality. Now let's look into the history of augmented reality. Where did it all start? Starting with the 1968, where head mounted display were first developed, right? With moving on to 1975, where Kruger, he developed video displays where user can literally interact with the virtual objects. Then in 1999, Hirokazu, he developed AR Toolkit, which is a prime software example to develop the augmented reality apps. In 2009, Esquire magazine published in one of the famous magazine for men, they printed this augmented reality feature of Robert Downey Jr. on their front page. Then in 2013, car manufacturers started using augmented reality into their service manuals, as well as in their one of the key components like dashboards, to get the more information out of these devices. Then in 16, almost it has crossed the billion dollar market worldwide. So this kind of history, rich history, has enabled augmented reality to come into mainstream. It's still limited, but more and more devices are being developed. Talking about the market size of augmented reality, almost 2020 figures are almost $18.8 billion worth of market size is there for the augmented reality, apart from the virtual reality, right? So huge market opportunities is there with this field of technology. Talking about how does this technology works, how does this augmented reality works? So it is based on three factors, starting with the visualization. So you get the vision based on the sensors. You have this visualization and tracking based on the sensing technology. GPS trackers are there, marker-based technology is there. You get the tracking as well as the visualization of this real world. You also place this virtual objects on the top of this real world based on this visualization as well as the tracking mechanism. Out of that, once you have placed it, we can easily interact with the help of this advanced sensing technologies we will discuss later on. You can use this for the interaction purpose. So let's talk with the first step, where this camera does the three types. Let's say, for starting with the vision cameras, we have the GPS based tracking is also there, and marker based tracking is also there to acquire the information of the object within the real world. Then you have the sensors, for example, barometric sensor is there, accelerometer sensor is there, so that they can sense the movement and depth of the object. Once they have tracked and sensed the object, they can interact with each other. At the final step, you can implement that kind of movement, real-time movement, into the AR technology, and you can get this digital information onto the top of the real world. right? So, and it is happening within the real time because you are continuously monitoring with the help of the tracking technology as well as the GPS. So let's look into the application of augmented reality, starting with the urban areas where you have, we already discussed that they are using within the car manufacturing, where they can put on the dashboards so that they can get the real-time information about traffic, about the congestions. These kind of informations are available right on the dashboard. Then you have for the rescuing operations, they can have informed decisions making for the rescue operations first. Responders, they can get more information with the help of this augmented reality. Then in entertainment industry, specifically education industries, it is extensively used. The prime example is I already discussed about Microsoft HoloLens, which is being used to view and to study in depth about this, let's say, for example, heart, internal workings, internal organs, internal components of this kind of organs, and their working can be easily be understood with the help of augmented reality devices like Microsoft HoloLens. In entertainment industry, specifically gaming industries, you have Pokemon Go, which is a very good example for which uses augmented reality. Then in marketing, we have billboards, displays, packaging, where you can get more information, you can interact with your customers, you can have more interactive sessions with the customers and more information about the product with the help of this kind of technology like augmented reality. Now let's look into the benefits derived out of this augmented reality. As discussed before, we have more information because we are dealing with the perceptual information being laid on the top of the virtual real world. We can get more user can get more information out of the scenario, right? Also, tracking is very accurate in the sense that you are using a real-time tracking, right? And it is efficient, right? Then you have interaction, better interactions, because you are also overlaying the overlaying one of the layer of a virtual world or object, virtual object or information on the top of real real world view. You can have a better interaction, but with it comes with some of the hurdles, like it is bulky. This kind of display devices, these HUDs, right, heads up displays are very, augmented reality displays are very bulky to wear, right? Then you also have this privacy concerns, right? You can get the information of the persons you are scanning by wearing, get the maximum information, digital information about, and it is about the person, or you can set a target without him knowing, him or her knowing. So this security concerns are also there, privacy concerns are also there. And here you are dealing with the virtual world more and more, so that you are literally detached with the physical world. And finally, the restriction is that you have to have the accurate tracking mechanism to get this working. Now, talking about the future of the augmented reality, where this technology is heading to, starting with this AR glasses, in near future, Apple, one of the leading company in technology, they are going to come up with this augmented reality glasses into the market. And other companies are already have been introduced, like say, for example, Google Glass, they have already introduced Google Glasses in the market. Then we have AR windshields, where the car manufacturers allow the users to have maximum information without affecting the driving pattern, so that they can have intelligent decision making while driving. And finally, we have AR contact lenses inbuilt into the viewpoint of the user for getting the more and more perceptual information. So these are some of the key technologies and future scope of the augmented reality. And it is very well developing into the Industry 4.0 scenario. So that's all from my side in this today's lecture. We have introduced a new technology which is a part of Industry 4.0, which is augmented reality. Augmented reality as well as virtual reality both provides key features in the development of Industry 4.0. We introduce what are the applications of the AR, how does this AR work, what are the patterns of working of the AR within the stepwise patterns. And finally, we looked into the future scope of augmented reality as well, with the market conditions and market size of the augmented reality. In next lecture, we will be focusing on the hardware and software component of augmented reality. Till then, goodbye.